I'm Yolande Poirier from Oracle Technology Network, and I'm here today with Thierry Vasiersenko.
Hello.
And Jim Weaver.
Hello.
So Thierry, tell us a little bit about what you do.
I'm working at General Electric in the healthcare business and developing our dose management software for following up the patients.
And Jim, everybody knows you, but just...
I'm a technology ambassador for Oracle, being an ambassador for Java and JavaFX.
So you both just finished like a conference session. And so tell us a little bit, what did you cover in this session?
Well, Thierry actually submitted the session, so maybe you should go first.
We talk about JavaFX 2 and the way you can create your own application using JavaFX 2 and the new features about it. And Jim presented us the whole new functionality of JDK 8 applying to JavaFX 8.
Okay. So the anything to add, Jim?
Oh yeah, it was fun because Thierry actually submitted the talk as a French-speaking talk. So Thierry did his entire half en français. And then I did my half speaking in English, but my slides were in French because Thierry had translated them. And so then, plus while I was speaking in English, and then Thierry translated each sentence I said into French. So it was a really neat experience, and he did a fantastic job with it.
Thank you.
That's a true like bilingual presentation.
Absolutely, yes. That's
good,
right.
Good job.
Yes.
So JavaFX, tell us a little bit what is exciting with JavaFX right now.
For me, the exciting thing is FXML, where you can build your own UI using XML files, and it's much more easier than what we did in Swing, for example, in the Java world. And what is really exciting for me too is the whole custom components. You can create custom components from scratch or inherit from other components and customize them the way you want.
Some of the things I find exciting that I talked about in the presentation were the things coming along with JDK 8. And one of the things is Lambda expressions. Lambda expressions really make event handling a lot easier. Because we don't have to use as much boilerplate code, and we can use now finally closures to do event handling. Then I also talked about some of the 3D features, and I drilled down into 3D, which is a really exciting area, and there's a lot of business cases for 3D. I showed the demo that Canoe Corporation and Navis are doing that we showed at Java 1. Where they're using 3D to manage shipping containers in the shipping yard. And then I went through some miscellaneous features that are coming in JavaFX 8.
And what are some of those features?
Oh, just a laundry list of them, like we're getting a date picker. There's a really nice style that the JavaFX engineering team has come up with, led by this effort led by Jasper Potts. It's called Modena, where it's replacing Caspian as the new style, and it's just an upgraded, very, very nice looking style for controls like buttons and things like that. So that date picker, the fact that we're supporting embedded like Raspberry Pi, but then also Java SE embedded for ARM processors and things like that. They're just very exciting and new things coming down the pike.
Any demos? Did you do a demo as well during the talk, or you didn't get it?
Yeah, Thierry did several demos.
I did a little demo of an application modifying an image by modifying the red, blue, and green values for that image, just to show how we can customize everything and how we can interact using image ops available in JavaFX.
So Thierry, you are working with JavaFX for work, but also you're contributing to certain like open source projects, right?
Yeah, I'm contributing to JF Extra, which is a bunch of new control, customized control with a lot of stuff in it, where you can use them from out of the box inside your JavaFX applications. And I'm doing a breadcrumb control to add this this concept into a JavaFX application.
Terry has also been doing lots of presentations at with Java Users Group in France in several locations. He's actually a former teacher of for corporate Java classes. And so he's a very seasoned, experienced teacher, and that really showed in the presentation he did today. Very animated, very very descriptive, to where the audience really picked up the concepts, I believe, that that he was talking about. So it was really, really nice. He's a real pro with that.
Thank you.
Yes.
So Jim, tell us a little bit about what is happening with the JavaFX community. I mean, you have like a community online on java.net, so can you tell
That's right, yeah, the URL is javafxcommunity.com, and it's growing daily. More bloggers are blogging about new things that they're doing, and the excitement is really getting very high. And they're communicating with each other. That's how I met Thierry. He was blogging about things that he was doing and tweeting about them. And so the community is really escalating into a very close-knit and you know, one that are really innovating things in open source and just showing each other examples, and we're learning from each other. So it's really been neat.
So any examples of applications or things that people are doing?
Oh, my word, yes. Like, for example, Garrett Grunewald from Canoe. He's been doing lots of things with embedded, like, you know, Raspberry Pi. And, of course, he's got a great graphics eye. And so he's been creating some really, really nice-looking controls.
Also available in JFX Trust. So
that's right, yes.
It's very, very beautiful and easy to use.
And then others have been, you know, like Henrik Ebers and others have been doing things, some really nice applications and showing some examples of what can be done. Others are starting to blog about patterns that they're discovering using JavaFX and then advocating. And so just on and on, in different dimensions of development and, you know, frameworks and things like that.
Okay. So, and have you seen? So, it's is it this this all this feedback recent, or I mean, is there like a momentum growing?
There's a momentum growing. Yes. Ever since we put the JavaFX community page out there, the number of bloggers has been growing, and the frequency of blog posts and tweets has been growing. Yes.